What's up, guys, and welcome back to Mafia 2. Waking up. Looks like it's the middle of the night, huh? Interesting. Who would be calling at an hour like this? Oh, no, it's light outside. Nah.
Hello?
It's pretty dark.
Is this Vito?
Who's asking?
Name's Leon. I'm the bartender at the Lone Star. I'm ringing you because Joe Barbaro gave me your number. Says he's a friend of yours.
Yeah. What about him?
Well, old Joe been guzzling my top shelf hooch all night long, dribbling on about some cat named Marty, and now he done just gone plain salty on me.
What the hell you talking about?
Your friend is out of control, man. He all waving his gun around and shit, and we can't talk no sense to him.
Great.
Now look, I ain't looking for no trouble with you fellas. Could you please come pick his drunk ass up before he shoots somebody or somebody calls the police? Vito, you got to come on down here and pick his ass up. You coming or not?
I'm coming,
right there. And hey, don't give him any more booze till I get there.
I'ma try, but your friend, he ain't gonna be down with that. You dig?
Hey, if you don't cut him off right now, I'm gonna cut you off when I get there. Got it?
All right, man.
Look at that fantastic hairline.
All right, how many people are in the bar right now?
Just me now. Joint was jumping about an hour ago. But now everybody done gone and split.
All right, listen. Lock the place up till I get there. I'll be there in a minute.
Okay, gotcha.
So you guys know in the last episode we did the big job, the big bomb job. Oh, shoot, we got to put some clothes on before we head out there. We did the big bomb job and blew things up and not everything went to plan. And Marty ended up eating a bullet. Obviously, Joe is very shaken up about that, and he's trying to drink away his sorrows here, which never a good idea, never actually helps, that's for sure. Only compounds those emotions and makes them worse, so we're going to go pick our sad drunk friend up, and hopefully we can console him and kind of bring him back to a good mental state.
Oh, Vito, you here? Right.
Where is he?
Over in the corner there. Now look, I tried to cut him off, but the motherfucker was gonna air my ass out if I did.
Okay, lock that door and just give me a minute with him. Had a couple, huh? How you feeling?
Vito, about time you showed up. Everybody went home already.
Gee, Joe, I wonder why.
Oh.
Yeah, right. You drive here?
Took a cab. I wouldn't park my car in this neighborhood.
All right, finish your drink and let's go.
Could you put the gun down, bro?
Marty, I'll let you out.
Here's to you, kid. You went out like a man.
Shit, now where'd I put my keys?
I'm so sorry, kid. This never should have happened. Never should have happened.
Oh, Jesus!
Ah, shit.
You gotta be kidding. What the fuck is wrong with you?
I was just...
You were just what? Shut your fucking mouth and get your drunk ass outside.
All right. I'm gone.
Poor guy. Straight up murdered, bro. Drag the body to the bartender's car. Well, this did not go to plan. Definitely gonna want to go dispose of this somehow. Dude was doing us a solid, too. That's the bad part. He saved Joe from getting in a ton of trouble, and look what happened because of it. One tap to the dome. We are gonna get you home, buddy. I think you need a couple glasses of water, pop a couple Tylenols, and just fall asleep. Everything's gonna be all right in the morning, and maybe we could get you a therapist, because it kind of feels like you need one. Dude, we've driven so far, and he hasn't said a word. He must be just straight up knocked out. I don't blame him. I probably would be too. He's very obviously kind of overindulged himself a little bit. Usually he's such a big talker, complaining about us going through red lights and our e-brake drifting and all kinds of stuff like that, but he hasn't said a word, dude. Alright. We made it!
Alright, we're here. Try not to shoot anybody on the way to the front door, huh?
Thanks, Vito. And hey, I'm sorry.
Look,
about...
just call me tomorrow, okay?
Now, what in the world are we going to do with this body? To be honest, I kind of forgot about the whole bartender getting shot thing. I was not expecting that. All right. Looks like we're going to go dump this thing. Oh, my goodness, dude. We just did a slide into that car in front of a cop with a dead body in our trunk. That could have been significantly worse than what just happened there. I remember this now. We're just gonna crush the whole car. Why leave any evidence? You know what I mean? Let's just get rid of the whole thing. We're gonna drive this bad boy into the press. Go ahead and destroy the car with the panels upstairs. Here we go. This would be a pretty nasty ooh. Definitely be a pretty nasty thing. There's still gonna be a lot of blood and organs and all kinds of stuff that comes out of that, but it looks like it doesn't actually show that, thankfully. All right. Well, we're gonna head back home. Did Joe a solid there. Prevented him from being, you know, charged with murder. Pretty good friend. We're going to see you guys in the morning for the next chapter. Chapter 11. A Friend of Ours. Somebody at the door?
What the hell is that?
Gotta answer this bad boy. I'm gonna go ahead and get in my clothes first. Don't wanna look like we're just getting out of bed for whoever our visitor is.
Hey, Vito. Long time no see.
Sure. Long time. What do you want, Henry?
A drink. Let's take my car.
Uh-oh. All right. Henry, I'm awfully glad that you weren't involved in our little escapade. Little explosion of fun
well,
the other
Clemente's
day.
He's dead, along with everybody else. Listen, Vito, I know Falcone had something to do with this. And I'm worried that he's going to want to take out what's left of the family.
And I should care about this, why?
Well, yeah, look, about you going away. I'm sorry for what Clemente did to you. But he got what was coming to him, right? I don't give a rat's ass about that old bastard. Matter of fact, I'd work for Falcone just the same.
You saying you want to join up with us?
Yeah, and since you work for him, I thought maybe you think you could put in a good word for me.
Absolutely.
Yeah, sure. Me and Joe can vouch for you.
Thanks, Vito. I owe you one.
No problem, boss.
So, how's life?
You mean before or after half the guys I know got killed? That business at the hotel. You wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
Got no idea what you're talking about.
That's funny, because a buddy of Joe's got popped in the parking lot that day. So I just figured you two were in on it.
Buddy of Joe's? Who are you talking about?
You know, that fucking kid used to come into Freddy's with Joe all the time. What's his name? Mikey, Mickey, whatever the fuck his name was.
You mean Marty?
Yeah, that's the kid. Kid had a voice like fucking Minnie Mouse.
Yeah, that's him.
I heard about that.
So you sure you weren't there that day? You're positive?
Let's put it this way. Me and Joe were out taking care of something for our boss that day. That's all I'm gonna say.
You know what? It don't matter anyway. But do me a favor, would you?
Yeah, sure.
Next time, get a better disguise than a phony fucking mustache. I saw you two pricks from a mile away.
You know what? Can we please not talk about this right now? Or ever again?
Don't worry about it. You did what you had to do.
I love it, dude.
You ever get the feeling you'd be better off in a different line of work?
To be honest with you, not really. This is what I am. What I'm good at.
Yeah. Now I guess it pays a hell of a lot better than being a fucking taxi driver.
I was thinking about skipping town after that business at the hotel. But where am I gonna go? What am I gonna do? That's why I came to see you.
So I was your last resort, huh? Thanks. Enough or nothing. How come you came to see me and not Joe?
Look, Joe's solid. But I wouldn't exactly want him speaking on my behalf. You know what I mean?
That makes sense. All right, let's head inside, see what we got going on. Hopefully a merging of two families here. Split our differences and work together.
Hey, Vito.
You got that money for me?
Always keep my word, don't I? Here you go. Don't spend it all in one place.
Thanks. Where's Joe?
He was here before, but then he left. Looked pissed off. Though lately, he always looks pissed off.
Yeah, can you blame him? Listen, I need to talk to you about something.
Well, what, is it important? I'm busy with Vinci right now. He's planning to make a move on us, and we don't know how or why. I gotta sort this shit out.
Yeah, well, I think it's worth hearing me out.
All right, go ahead, but make it quick.
All right. A guy I know who worked for Clemente called me. He's worried. He's not sure if we'll be going after the rest of Clemente's guys or not.
Oh, that's good. As far as I know, the boss ain't planning nothing at this point, unless they try something stupid.
Okay, well, this guy also asked me if he could come work for us.
Yeah? Who is it? What, is he a friend of yours?
I did a few jobs with him for Clemente. Really knows his shit.
Okay, tell him to stop by.
Well,
he's right here?
He's here right now.
He is? All right. Go get him, then.
Eddie, this is Henry Tomasino. Henry, this is Eddie Scarpa.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Scarpa.
Don't call me Mr. Scarpa. My friends call me Eddie. Now, take a seat, Henry. So, Vito tells me you want to join up with us.
Yeah, I'm out of work right now. And I don't want to make a big deal out of what happened.
Now that's good thinking. Tell me something first, Henry. Were Clemente and Vinci planning anything against our organization?
Okay. I usually keep my nose out of things like that. But I was with Luca Guarino once at Leo Galanti's place. And Luca was going on and on about Falcone being involved in some dirty business and that something should be done about it. I think he was trying to turn Vinci against you.
That bastard. I'll bet he was talking about drugs all the while he's dealing them himself. He knows that Vinci is totally against us. Yeah, probably fooled the old man good. So that's why he's planning to move on us. No, we gotta hit him first.
Again?
Hey, if we don't act, Frank will. First, we gotta get rid of Galante. Without him, Frank's fucked.
Leo?
I wanted to keep you out of it, but I didn't have anybody else who could pull off a job like this.
That's
now
sad.
I'm thinking this could be the perfect opportunity for Henry here to prove himself. What do you say, Henry? You up for it?
If it means I'm in when the job's done, sure.
Exactly. Take care of Leo. Now what about you, Vito? I'd feel a lot better if you went with Henry to make sure everything goes smooth. And I don't mean you gotta whack the guy. Just drive there, wait until it's done, and drive back. But if it don't feel right, I can ask somebody else instead. What do you say?
Sorry, Eddie, I can't do this. Leo was like a father to me back in the can.
Yeah, I understand. Well, looks like you gotta take care of this yourself, Henry. You can hire some help if you want, but you gotta do this so nobody suspects it was us. Leo lives in Highbrook.
Got it. Don't worry. It'll be done today.
Okay, you better get going then.
See you later, Eddie.
It's a good thing you brought him here. Even if he screws up, nobody'll know it was us.
The perfect pawn.
He's gonna screw it up.
That's good. Well, Vito, I got nothing else for you today, but drop by tomorrow, okay?
Yeah. I'll see you later, Eddie.
See ya.
Poor Leo, man. He was so good to us. He took care of us. I guess we're gonna go warn him. Let's go save his life. Don't want to get to Leo fast. Henry's going to be there soon. Uh-oh. All right. We're just going to go ahead and smash the window then. Just break it in. Break it in, baby. Here we go. Whew. Going against the family. This is not the best idea. Definitely not the best idea here. But we're going to do what we feel is right, baby. We've got that moral compass we've got to take care of. So let's get after. Oh shoot, dude, that is clicking down fast. We're already three quarters of the way. Only three quarters of the way left. One quarter of the way there, I guess, is a better way to say it. That clock don't stop, baby, and this ain't the this isn't the fastest car in the world. Definitely a bit of a slowpoke, but We're gonna make it work. Gotta watch out for cops. Dude, I hate when they pull up on those perpendicular streets. You don't really see them until the last minute. You really have to use the mini map in this game, that's for sure. All right, bank a right here, followed by a left. Looking good so far. A little under halfway left. Hit another left here. I love using the e-brake in this game, dude. It actually feels pretty solid. I wish they had like races. Some street races. I don't think the Mafia really got into street racing, though. Gonna be going up here. Dude, I don't know if we're gonna be able to make it in time. Isn't this that road that, like, loops really, really heavily? Holy cow, we got one quarter of the time left. Come on, baby. Watch out for oncoming traffic. We're good. We got a cop coming the other way, too, so we're gonna have to slow down. Bro, I don't think we're gonna make it. I mean, I tried. Gotta watch out for this cop. I'm just hoping he doesn't say anything. I mean, it's not like we were going over the speed limit. We were going 40 there, so that's good. It's just we were cutting through. Dude, I don't think we could have cut that any closer. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Leo, you here?
How the hell did you get in here? Get out of here. Oh, shut
this gun up. Leo, put it away. It's me, Vito.
Vito? What the hell are you doing here? You could have called
me. Leo, there's no time to talk. You gotta get out of here. Quick, they're after you.
What? Come upstairs, Vito. My feet are getting cold. You want a drink?
Oh, I want a drink. What the fuck is wrong
with you? Okay, so what's happening?
Look, Falcone wants you dead. The guys are on their way. You gotta get out of here.
Why the hell would I do that?
Look, Falcone heard Vinci's planning to make a move on him because Clemente lied and said he was in the dope business.
Lied? Vito, Carlo Falcone is in the dope business. Everybody knows that. Clemente tried to muscle his way into the business, so Falcone got rid of him. Now he wants to get rid of us, too, before we make a move on him.
How do you know all this?
I got my sources. Why did you come here again?
Why? What are you getting senile on me? Because they're gonna kill you. Stop talking, for Christ's sake. Get dressed and let's go.
Why don't we just get rid of whoever Carlos sent to whack me? We got the advantage. They don't know we're expecting them.
I can't do that. I know the guy. I'm actually the one who got him the job.
You hired your friend to whack me?
No, not exactly. Look, I don't have time to explain. He's gonna be here any minute.
Okay, wait here. I'll get dressed.
Shit, too late. They're here. Oh, shit. Henry can't see me here. We gotta hide. Quick, before he comes up here.
Oh, man, dude. Escape with Leo. Don't let him see you. Where are we supposed to go? Through here? Where do you want me to go, bro? Where do you want me to go? Where do you want me to go?
Maybe we can fit in here.
You gone nuts?
In this?
What, the both of us? I ain't no queer. I ain't gonna lock myself in a cabin.
Hold on, just get in there, Leo. We don't have time.
Hey, don't stand so close.
You move over.
No, you move over.
Shh, shut up.
Hey, that better be your gun.
Shut up.
What the hell?
Hey, Henry.
Vito?
This your friend?
No, he just wants to hang up his jacket.
All right, come on, come on, get out of there. It's about damn time you come out of the closet. Take a seat. What the hell is going on here?
Look, Henry, Leo's a friend of mine, all right? He helped me out when I was in prison. He pretty much saved my life. And he's the reason I got made. Look, I didn't know that he was gonna put a contract out on him. I had to warn him. You gotta understand.
Yeah, but you gotta understand that I can't afford to screw this up. If I let Leo go, Falcone will think I fucked him on purpose and I'll have me killed.
Damn it, Henry. I'm your friend here. I'd do the same thing for you and you know it.
This has nothing to do with friendship, Vito. This is business. And if I screw up, I'm done. I can't let him go. I took a contract and I gotta finish the job. If you don't want to watch, you can leave. And don't worry about me. I won't tell anybody you were here.
Look, Leo told me that all of this is because Falcone's into drugs. He's breaking the rules and he wants to get rid of anybody who knows about it.
So what? The only people who aren't breaking those rules are Frank Vinci and Leo here. And those aren't the people who pay me.
Vito, thanks for everything. But leave us now. I've had a long, good life. And it's not worth risking your neck to buy an old man a few more years.
No, Leo. There's gotta be a way.
Vito. Go.
This is so sad.
Sorry, Vito. I won't tell anybody you were here. Just make sure nobody sees you leave. Me big for this one, pal.
What?
Hey, kid.
Leo.
We got a plan, baby. Drink?
What the hell happened?
Your friend and I made a deal. I'm gonna disappear. There's nothing left for me in this town anyway since my wife passed. And I was planning to retire someplace warm anyway.
Nice. Fake the death.
First, let's get out of here before your friend changes his mind.
We're good to go, baby. That's GTFO, and we're going to take him to the train station. He's going to be able to get out of here. How do I get out of this house, bro? Got to go out the back door, maybe? Ah, back here. Forgot, they can't see us, so we're going to have to go out the back door. I'll take this thing. Look at this. Nice navy blue. I mean, a convertible, be able to hide our identity, okay. Probably isn't the best idea, but
over to the train station,
we'll do it.
This town's been good to me. Now it's time to say goodbye.
You gonna go there in your PJs?
Damn right I am. I'd rather be alive in my pajamas than dead in a three-piece suit.
You, gonna tell Frank what happened?
Sure I am. But don't worry, I ain't gonna mention your name. You're gonna have enough to worry about as it is.
Thanks, Leo. You know, this whole thing
We're good.
Got complicated. Real fast, you know?
Of course it did, Vito. What did you expect? You swear the oath, you put on a fancy suit, and then it's one big party? Carlo's always been a shady bastard. Even for guys in this business. I've been warning Frank about him for years.
So what are you gonna do now?
I'm gonna disappear. Let things run their course. I'm gonna take the first train to Lost Heaven. Make a few phone calls, settle my affairs. Then I'm gonna head for the airport. I'm gonna go someplace warm. This time tomorrow, I'm gonna be sitting on a beach somewhere. Sipping one of them fruity drinks with the umbrella in them.
Now that sounds nice.
Carlo wants me dead, and sticking around here is like buying a one-way ticket to the morgue. All right, here it is. Thanks for everything, Vito. Just promise me that you're never gonna be as stupid as you were today. Risking your neck like this just to buy an old man a few more years.
Enjoy your vacation, old man.
Dude, I wanna go somewhere on a beach, warm weather with a fruity drink in my hand, bro. Like, I'm not even getting hunted by the mob. And I can't do that. We're quarantined. Nobody can travel. But that's all right. We'll survive. Long as we have our video game. So bam, nice. Contract completed. Helped out a friend. Helped out an even older friend. Nobody had to die and everybody won. That is how you operate business, baby.
What to do? I can't go back home. I don't want to see him ever again.
Whoa, what happened? See who?
Eric.
Your husband, why?
He drinks and he parties all the time.
Does he hit you?
No, but he's seeing somebody. I know he is.
Does he hit you?
Sometimes.
Son of a bitch, I'll kill him.
No, Vito, please don't hurt him. I just thought you could talk to him. He'll listen
Where
to
is
you.
He?
I don't know. He has a friend who lives on River Street. That's
okay,
usually
okay,
where
right.
he is.
It's gonna be all right. All right, listen. Hey, when you feel better, you go on home. I'll talk to Eric. That bastard doesn't come back today and apologize. You call me, but don't worry. I have a feeling he will.
Okay, Vito, but please don't hurt him. Please.
Don't worry. I'll go talk some sense into him, okay?
Yeah, we're just gonna talk. I can be very convincing. Don't worry about it, Frankie. We'll take care of your relationship problems. Find Eric at the apartment on River Street. All right. I mean, I'm kind of thinking we just bust one of these windows here. Our other car is a little bit beat up. We kind of ran into a couple things on the way here, so we're gonna let that chill in the garage for a moment, and we're gonna roll out in this thing. A little bit less conspicuous. Let's go handle business. Nobody puts their hands on my sister. Looks like this might be the spot. Time to go find out where this dude lives. I feel like I'm in L.A. Noir or something, bro. Let's look at the mailboxes, get the name, that sort of thing. Is it up top? Gotta be somewhere in here. Brother, keep it together. Well, 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 what do we have here? Make it out with a new chick. Beautiful. Ooh, okay, okay. He's got moves. We gotta be a little bit quicker on a counter, I think. He certainly has a decent aura about himself, even though he's drunk. Dude, he's dodging our punches and stuff. He should be a really easy hit, right? Hit him with the haymakers here. Beautiful. And he's out.
Consider this a warning. You touch my sister again, I will fucking kill you. Alright?
Yeah.
From now on, you're gonna stay home. Stay off the dope, stop the drinking, and make sure she's fucking happy.
Look at his eye!
If ever she's not happy, I'll find you and finish the fucking job. You got it?
Yeah. Phone's ringing. See what this is all about.
Vito, it's Francesca. Eric came home and he's all beat up. You said you wouldn't hurt him.
He probably got in a fight. You know, he's been hanging out with a very bad crowd.
He apologized for everything, Vito. He promised he'll be good to me. It's all okay now. So you'll leave him alone, won't you?
Hey, whatever you want. But if he hurts you again, I'll kill him.
Yep.
Listen to yourself, Vito. I don't know you anymore. Look, you stay away from us, you understand? Stay away.
Oh, stop being so emotional, woman. You're fine. I'm just protecting you. You're welcome for fixing your domestic abuse situation. Looks like we got an even worse situation here, though.
Do it now, Barn. You dago cunt, Barn.
My house.
Shoot. Okay, we gotta go out back here. Is our bathroom? We got a window or something? Yes, bathroom window. Oh boy. We got a lot of fellas here. I think we gotta run, bro. Go to Joe's. Okay, just run, Vito. Just run. Just run, Vito. If they see you, you are donezo, bro. You just gotta get out of here. You gotta go find a car on the street or something. Oh shoot, they're kind of checking the neighborhood for you, bro. Stop, 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 stop. Hey, you, give me your car. Right now. Actually, just kidding. Give me the one behind you. This one's way nicer. Not that I really have a choice right now. Go. Go, 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 go. Oh my gosh. Okay. We're good. Do you guys see that? We lost $15,000. I'm assuming that was the price of our house. That's crazy to think about a house costing 15 G's, bro. But you gotta think about it. Cars back in this area were like 2 G's. Man. Lost our entire wardrobe, lost our entire garage with all of our vehicles and everything. This is just, this is just not good. This thing flies, bro. That's a cop. There's no way that we didn't just get pulled over right there. Seriously, though. I mean, we got this dual exhaust. Sounds absolutely amazing. Out of my way, bro. I'm gonna run this thing into the ground. It's not like it's mine anyway. We had one of these, and we lost it from our last mission. It didn't respawn for us, so that's kind of upsetting. cop up above us on the freeway there. Don't gotta worry about that, but hey, at least we got Joe. Hopefully he's over his drinking bender. Hopefully he's in a better spot mentally. And hopefully he's gonna be down to help us. Showed up half naked. Looking for some help from a bro. Joe, you aren't gonna believe what happened to me, fam. This is a heck of a night.
Joe, don't tell me you're not home.
Come on. He's home. He's gotta
be. Let's go. You better not be passed out. Come on!
All your horses. I'm coming.
Joe, we got an issue.
Are you barbecuing in your underwears?
Yeah. Can I come in?
Oh, yeah, of course. I'll fix you a drink.
I like what you've done with the place.
Nice, ain't it?
What the hell happened to this place?
I spruced the joint up a little. What do you think?
Yeah, it's really, different.
Low-key, I really like it.
I decorated it myself.
I mean, the pink's a little questionable, but I like the flamingos and stuff. I like the cash on the table.
So what the hell happened? Here, take this.
Those crazy fucking Micks.
What about them? What'd they do?
They tried to fucking kill me.
What?
And they burned my fucking house down.
Son of a bitch. So what are you gonna do? You wanna go deal with the Micks right now?
Hell yeah, I do.
All right, relax. Have a drink. Let me make a few phone calls. And, take a look at my closet. Unless you wanna go on a rampage in your skivvies.
Thanks. Thought you'd never ask.
All right. Well, I'm down to do it in my underwear, but... Looks like we're gonna have to pick something.
Hey, Joe. Yeah, I know, but I need a favor. A bunch of Micks try to kill a good friend of mine tonight. Point this house down.
Oh,
I want to know who they are and where they're operating out of.
I love it, dude.
Hey, you're gonna have a lot worse to worry
about.
Letting
the chest meat hang out.
Mickey Desmond. Oh, he is.
Love how he has more than one of this shirt.
Where is he now? Yeah, I know the place. All right, thanks. Hey, you finally got some style. I'm gonna want that shirt back, by the way. They don't make treads like those no more.
Yeah, there's a reason for that, you know? Where are we going?
The Hill of Tara, the Mick joint in Kingston. Come on, I'll tell you the rest in the car.
All right. Let's get out of here, bro. Oh, I'm sorry, in your way? Okay. You open the door for me, that's right.
Come on, get in.
Sounds good, bro. I mean, she's a little beaten up, but she's alright. She'll get us there.
So you heard anything about the Micks lately?
Nah, nothing. Why?
The Micks got themselves a new boss. Name's Mickey Desmond. There's a few other guys who want to take his spot. So he's trying to show everybody that he means business.
What the hell does that have to do with me?
Brian O'Neill. He was Desmond's cousin.
I should have known.
My money's on him being down at that shithole joint right now, laughing it up with the rest of those fucking yo-yos.
So let's get over there and deal with him.
That's the plan. Sounds like there ain't many of them left. So I guess we should just storm the place, surprise the shit out of
him. I like this plan. Assholes burnt my fucking house down.
Relax, we'll be there in a minute.
Dude, I hate getting behind cops in this game just as much as I do in real life.
Yeah, if you got one, that'd be good. I'll just beat him to death with my bare hands. It makes no difference to me.
Should be one in here somewhere. Here it is. Here you go.
Thanks.
How big of pockets do you have, bro? Seriously, though, like, we're kind of stuck in front of these guys. We can't really peel off on them because if we go too fast, they'll end up pulling us over there. They stop back there. All right, we're good. Out of my way. Out of my way, bro. Out of my way. So we're just gonna go bum rush them, just the two of us. We're in the family, we got people we could call who can handle business. And we're just gonna go take care of this ourselves. I like that.
Hey, you just went through a red light.
Oh, how I missed you, Joe.
Come on, let's go get these fucks.
Let's do it. See what these boys are up to.
I told you, I chased him, but I lost him. The coward ran away, but I'll find him.
And when I do...
You were the one who ran away, asshole.
Oh, fuck. You. You've got some balls.
Yes, I do.
We better get down. All right, we got a piece here. Dude, that bartender had a freaking Tommy gun.
Come on, take a shot. Hurry up here.
I'm hurting here. He's down.
I'm gonna get on your bad side. I'm the best.
Whew. Where's this last guy at? Is he behind this booth, or is he all the way? Is he all the way in the back of the restaurant? Is he back here? What's up, buddy? We got him. All right, got the grease gun. Looks like he's trying to get away. That's not gonna work, brother. That is not. That is not gonna work on us. All right, let's chase him down. Oh shoot, we got some cops on us here. Let him get close, and then I'm gone. Let's go. Let him get out of the car so they can't chase you as quickly. We should be able to get away from him right away. Here we go.
What the fuck are you doing?
What's up here?
That's what I'm talking about. Good hit there. Are you gonna shoot him here, or what's your plan? What's your plan, Joe? You want me to get out?
That takes care of that. Stupid fucks.
All right. Well, I mean, that was beautiful. Oh, take money from Desmond's? Okay, $500, not bad. I'm trying to move their car so I can get in mine. Can we enter through the passenger sign? We can. Okay.
You're fucking dead!
Who are you shooting at, Joe?
Take care of that, huh?
Yeah, but don't give me my house back.
Don't worry. Business is looking good. You'll have the cash for a new one real soon.
Yeah, I sure as hell hope so.
All right, let's go back home.
Beautiful, dude. Cash on your couch, right? That was awesome.
I can do one better than that. Here, take these keys. They're for Marty's apartment. I'm trying to get rid of it right now for his mother. So, you might as well use it while I do.
Thanks. Yes.
That's really
don't
sad.
Thank me, buddy. You're too old to be sleeping on my couch. Plus, I just bought the thing. I don't want you lousing it up. Marty's apartment's over in Oyster Bay.
So you're gonna have me drive all the way over there?
Really? What we did back there doesn't even start to make up for it.
Hey, all that stuff they got point up is just things, Vito.
Just things? Hey, those are my things, Joe. Why do you think I do the shit we do anyway? It's to buy things. Suits, cars, broads, houses. Now I'm back to scratch. All my damn cash was in that house, too. I promised myself I'd never be poor again. Fuck more frat than an old man.
Hey, I understand. Don't worry, we'll think of something. You'll be back on your feet in no time.
Glass is always fucking half full of you, isn't it?
Gotta watch out for these cops. Don't want to attract any more attention to us. But hey, we're all right, Vito. We got a cool car. It's a little beat up at this point,
yeah,
but...
see you around, I guess.
It's hanging
see
in
you, buddy.
There.
Sorry about tonight.
Can't even drive him up to the door. It's just gonna drop him off there. But yeah, we got a cool car that's hanging in there. We got $500 in our pocket from that dude that tried to kill us. You know what? Let me... Oop. Okay, you know what? It's not even worth it. I was gonna go take that so we could have a newer one, but we could pay to repair this one. We're gonna get... Oh, there's one right there. These are everywhere. It's almost like when you're in one, it makes them spawn more regularly. Don't even have to take the time... Oh, this one's kind of banged up, isn't it? Or it's just dirty. Never mind. Don't even have to... You know, pick the locks, because we could just, okay. But yeah, dude, we got some nice wheels. We got $500 in our pocket. Oh wow, look, another one. That's crazy. We're gonna be all right, buddy.
What a fucking dump. God, I wish I had the cash for a hotel.
I mean, we got $500 in our pocket, but yeah, dude. I mean, he was a young kid, so we'll cut him some slack, but he lived like a slob. Chapter 12, Sea Gift. Back at Marty's apartment.
My house burned to the ground, along with almost every penny I had. There was even some trouble with the cops, but Eddie took care of that. And since I didn't have any insurance, I had to live in this shithole of an apartment till I could get back on my feet. At least I managed to save Leo. He disappeared without a trace. I doubt Frank Vinci even knew where he went. And even though Henry failed to deliver on the contract, Eddie still brought him in when he heard Leo had skipped town. Me and Joe had a new partner.
All right, man. So, I mean, we've been knocked down here for sure, but at least things are starting to look up a little bit. Let's answer the phone and see what we got going on today. Who be calling me?
It's Henry.
Hey.
Listen, I'm setting up something big. I want you to come in on it. If you're interested in hearing more, come meet me at Lincoln Park and bring a piece.
Okay. I'll see you there.
Man. Up to some bad business. Gotta bring a piece, huh? Gotta go ahead and throw our Lincoln jacket back on and let's go do it, dude. This place really is kind of a piece. Kind of a POS. Not afraid to say it, but we're gonna be alright. Look at this thing. Nice. Hey, at least we still got our cars with us, bro. We must have some good insurance after that fire. Here we go. Got this old school muscle car. I'm digging it. Suits Vito well. We're gonna go see what our boy is up to. Dude, this thing is ridiculously fast. All right, we're good. Whew. We made it. Here we are at the park. What's going on, man? We having a picnic or what? What's the plan, bruv?
Hey, here he comes.
Hey.
What's up?
Hey, Vito. Take a seat.
All right, listen. I've been doing some research into Carlo's business.
So? So, the only reason he had Clemente killed was because he was selling dope, too. And he was stealing his customers. Now he just needs to get rid of one last obstacle. The one guy who could fuck things up and ruin his plan to become the main supplier for the whole city. Frank Vinci.
Where'd you get all this?
I talked to a few people I trust.
Okay, so what does this have to do with us?
Cause, if he can do it, why can't we? A kilo of heroin costs 2,500 bucks over in France. Then it's another 1,000 bucks to get it here.
And?
And we pick up 11 grand for just driving the stuff to the dealers. That's 7,500 bucks profit a kilo.
Yeah, but what about Falcone?
Some big money.
And even if he does, he'll just threaten us and demand the cut.
All right, but if Carlo's the only big supplier in the city, where are you going to buy the stuff from?
I'm way ahead of you. What do you two know about the Tongs?
The Chinks?
Some kind of organization for Chinese immigrants, right?
That's what I said, the Chinks.
Right, but it's also a front for their other operations. They run the Chinese quarter, and they keep to themselves. But some of them are interested in doing business with outsiders, and they need middlemen since most people are afraid to deal with them.
Sounds like a new partner to me.
Yep. They'll give us 10 kilos to start.
For how much?
35 grand.
And we can sell it for...
110.
Nice.
Okay, well, where the hell are we gonna get our hands on 35 grand?
I know a loan shark. The Yid over on Palisade. I think a loan is 35, we give him 45 back. Now that means our take is over 20 grand a piece. Not bad for just moving the shit from one place to another.
But you know, who's gonna end up using this crap?
What do you care? As long as it isn't an alligator.
Of course, Vinci was right. Drugs are bad news, they kill people.
Look, only idiots do drugs. Deadbeats and losers. If they want to kill themselves so badly, I'd gladly help them out. Especially for 20 grand.
That's such a mean outlook.
We got buyers in the ghetto. They'll take care of the distribution. So we don't need to worry about that. You guys in or not?
I'm in. Come on, don't be stupid, Vito. 20 fucking grand in one afternoon.
When?
Right now. If we don't take the offer, the Tongs will just find somebody else.
Come on, Vito, it'll be a piece of cake.
Let's go see Bruno then. Vito, how about you run us all down there? He's on Palisade Street.
Okay, let's go.
Bro, 20 G's a piece just for moving a little dope. That sounds fantastic. Also, I do believe I bought I brought a two-seater. Is there a back seat in this thing? Yeah, there's a back seat back there. Shoot. Maybe not. There is a back seat back there. Y'all are gonna make me leave this cool new car that I just pulled out of the garage. Come on, man. All right, gotta go get a four-door for all you fatties. Fucking Joe couldn't get in the back seat. Come on, bro. Hopefully there's no police around. Oh, there's a cop over there behind us. Looks like he's gone. All right, let's just bust the window here. It'll be quicker. Cop at that intersection, but they didn't see a thing, baby. That's what I'm talking about. We're off.
So who's this guy we're gonna see, Henry?
His name's Bruno. He's one of the only guys in town who could do a loan this big.
What if he doesn't give it to us, then what?
Then the deal's off. But don't worry, I know this guy. He'll give us the money.
There ain't nobody else we can get this kind of money from?
There's three other guys I know of. But if you want to ask Carlo or Frank Vinci for 35 grand, be my guest.
Yeah, no thanks.
Who's the third guy?
He ain't in business no more. Somebody blew up a room full of his guys and shot him point blank in the face with a Tommy gun.
Oh, that guy.
Come on, we said we wasn't gonna talk about that.
All right, so
I don't know what you're talking about.
Something.
I think he gets his money from some of the bosses from out of town who sit on the commission.
Yeah? No shit.
Yeah, which is why we can't stiff the guy. Besides, we gotta keep this quiet.
Can we trust him?
Sure. Wise guy's been borrowing money from this guy forever. As long as we pay him back on time, we won't have a problem.
But if we don't pay him back on time, then that's where we get a problem. So we just gotta make sure we are,
This is it. Stop here.
Very upfront, honest, and quick. Where is it? Back in the back? Probably could have pulled the car back here, huh? Looks like this is the spot. Bit of a sketchy meeting place, that's for sure.
Hi, fellas. We're here to see Bruno.
Hiya, Henry. If you got guns on yous, put them down there. I gotta search yous.
Hiya, Bruno.
Hello, Henry. So, to what do I owe the pleasure of your company today?
I need 35 grand in $20 bills.
Oh, that's a lot of money, Henry. A lot of money. Tell me, why should I give that much to a small-time guy like you, huh? Convince me.
I got a sure thing. You'll have 45 by the end of the week.
What kind of sure thing?
Sorry, Bruno. That's a trade secret.
Then 45 is not enough. I'd be more comfortable with 65.
That's a bit steep, even for you. 50 is all I can do.
Henry, Henry, I have no guarantee I'll get my money back. And you have nowhere else to go. So, how about 60? Don't think of it as interest. It's more like my cut of the profits.
55.
Feel like we're on Shark Tank, bro.
Anything more than that, it's not worth my time.
Deal. I'll give you $35,000 today, and you'll give me $55,000 by Friday. If you don't pay it back by then, the debt goes up by $10,000 every week.
Damn!
You'll get it by Friday.
Okay. Isaac, prepare $35,000 in $20 bills.
And they got that much in cash.
Henry, but if you screw me, remember these wise words from the Bible. And my wrath shall wax hot, and I will kill you with the sword, and your wives shall be widows, and your children fatherless.
Exodus, chapter 22, verse 24.
My man knows his
I'm
stuff.
Impressed. You don't seem like the church-going type. But just remember, the money isn't mine. So even if you get rid of me, that doesn't get rid of your debt. So no funny business, okay, boys?
Sure, Bruno.
Thank you, Isaac. You want to count it, Henry?
I'll take your word for it, and I'll bring it back on Friday along with your cut.
I hope so. Good luck, boys.
Man, he just yoinked another 15 or 20. 20 we settled at 55, right? So he, I guess 10. Another $10,000. Still, I don't want to give that up, bro. That's coming out of my pocket. All right, drive to the Seagift warehouse. Sounds good to me. We got our car. Oop. What the heck? Dude, It's a problem. When I go back and forth between playing LA Noir and this game, the sprint buttons and everything else are flip-flopped, bro. It's an issue. All right, boys, come on. Come on. Joe, come on.
Freeze!
Our boys got me. Let's go. Let's go, boys. Come on. Get the heck out of here. We got a jet. They ain't gonna find us. Our car's wanted, though. Shoot, we probably should have taken the cop car, huh?
Nice job, Henry.
Of course. I told you give us the dough, didn't I?
How come you know the Bible so good, Henry? You read it or something?
Holy cow. We're gonna have to steal this thing so that way we're not known by the license plate, but I mean, we're personally wanted, so this just threw a whole wrench in our plans.
I go to church on Sunday, so I asked the priest one time.
You go to church?
Yeah, and I can understand why you don't. They use big words, there's no hookers, and the food's lousy.
Yeah, that pretty much sums it up.
Jeez, I ain't been there since 45.
What? That time your mother made you go to confession?
Yeah, that time she smacked me for checking out some chick's coolie. Ah, God rest her soul.
How about you, Joe? How long's it been?
Easter.
Ah, that ain't too bad.
1941.
I take that back then. You're going straight to hell.
What, you just figuring that out now?
Don't worry. I'll save seats for the both of you. You know, I heard about a long shot named Bruno once. Must be the same guy.
Yeah? What'd you hear?
Well, you know Mickey the Crab, right?
What, the guy who cleans the bathrooms at Carlo's joint?
Yeah, the guy who's only got a finger and a thumb on his left hand.
Oof.
Guess how that happened. I heard he owed a lot of money to some yid from Southport. Get my drift?
Oh, right. I get the picture.
So he took care of business.
Crab's a moron. Not like that's gonna happen to us.
I certainly hope not. I hope this deal goes well. Yeah, dude, that was kind of a mess. So LA Noir R2 is the sprint button, as much sense as that makes, and then obviously it's the shoot button and pretty much everything else. So I go to press R2 to sprint here, and we end up shooting, which is not ideal. So we're gonna be fine though, as long as we kind of stay off the radar a bit. If we see any cops, we'll make sure to get away from them quickly. Don't get in any accidents, and we should be all right. Oops, there's a cop right here. We're good, baby. We're wanted, but they can't really see inside the car very well, so we're gonna be all right. Looks like we made it.
Now just follow me.
I don't see anything wrong with walking into an enemy gang's hideout with a suitcase full of cash.
You got some business with your boss.
Greetings, Mr. Tomasino.
I can't see how this would go wrong at all. Especially cash that isn't ours. This is not a good idea. Not a good idea at all. Leading us back into the sketchy back alley. Idiot.
Welcome, Henry.
Hello, Mr. Wong.
Let us get straight to business. Is your suitcase heavy enough?
See for yourself.
Yo, Doc, this is 10磅重的20元美金钞票，一共35,000块.
All right.
Weigh in the money.
And bring the goods. You're a good man, Henry. Here is your merchandise. Each bag contains 1 kilo. Each kilo weighs a little more than 2 pounds. Which one do you want to test?
Looks good. Take a little taste test.
Okay, we're good.
I'm glad. Next time, we can give you twice the amount.
For 70 large.
It was a pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Wong.
The pleasure was all mine.
I mean, seems like the start of a budding relationship, huh?
See how easy that was? Let's get back in the car.
We'll see if it works out that way.
All right, fellas, the hot part's over. Now we just gotta make the exchange and we're done.
Sounds good to me.
Where are we headed?
Hunters. I got it all lined up.
Can't even pull my guns out, dude. Weapons aren't allowed here. Well, that's not good.
Hello, gentlemen.
Fucking setup.
I think you have something for us. Drop the suitcases.
My shoes.
Wait a minute. These guys ain't cops.
Kill the bastard! Shoot me up!
I'm just gonna start blasting on everybody. Here we go. Got him.
Here comes more of them. Hold on.
Shoot. Nice job, buddy. That's what I'm talking about. Got a grease gun here. Let's go ahead and grab this guy, see what we can do. We got fellas down here. Good night. Right in the groin. That would hurt. All right, let's keep going, boys. We gotta run.
Stay away from these windows, fellas. No sense staying up here. Let's get down there.
All right.
Vito, kick the door in.
We're going, bro. Don't you worry. We got these guys coming into the warehouse. I am not stopping here, baby. This is personal. Y'all are not taking anything from me. Technically, this isn't even our money, bro. You picked the wrong group to mess with, man. He's down.
Take him out.
Got him running. He's down.
Is that the fucking best you got?
My guy's outside. He's down. Gotta be careful here. We are definitely taking a lot of damage. Not too bad. Appreciate you, Joe. Good work.
I won't want to get on your bad side.
You say that same thing almost every time, bro. Where is this last guy? He's somewhere in here, I think. Directly below us. Just camping out. Y'all see him? I think there's somebody else coming in as well. Oh, Joe's heading down already? You crazy mother sucker, bro. He go. Looks like we got more outside as well. He's down. Don't worry, guys. I'll just take care of it. Everything and everyone. Good night. Probably gonna pick up this dude's Thompson. Can I swap to it? It's not letting me. Did we not pick it up? I have no clue where it is. All right. GG.
Back me up, Vito.
I mean, one of us, there it is. I was gonna say, one of us has to hit this guy, right? We're all spraying him. Could you stop walking in front of me, Joe? I'd appreciate that, because you're kind of getting in the way here, bud.
Oh, you're in trouble. Shoot that guy.
A lot more guys to worry about here. Looks like there's one off to our right, too, which is my primary concern. Good night. Just handing out sleeping aids to these guys, bro. Take your Motrin. Is that what Motrin does? I'm not sure. Pop up. There you. About to get straight sprayed from a distance, baby. Come on. Okay, he's not popping up. He go. Not quite. Now he is. That's one way to do it. This guy's weak. He's down. All right. I'm gonna hop in one of these bad boys and let's ride, fellas. Looks like these wasps have been upgraded a bit. Seem fairly fast.
But what the fuck are you doing?
I'm getting out of here, bro. What are you talking about?
Well, yeah.
That was fucking close.
Let's go. Oh, shoot.
Not over yet.
They're coming after us. Fuck! Lose them!
Lose your pursuers, it says. All right.
Suspect is about 6 feet tall, dark hair, medium build. Copy that.
And now we got you guys shooting at cops like a couple of dingleberries. Stop shooting. The cops are going after the other guys. Let's go incognito and get the heck out of there, bro. Let's not just ring the dinner bell and let them know where we're at. Okay? Should we get out of the car and switch cars? I kind of feel like we probably should. Drive to the warehouse on Evergreen. Yeah, bro. Flip it. There's a car. There's
what
a cop
the
coming
fuck
this
was
way.
That, Henry?
No idea. Somebody else must have known about the deal. Those definitely weren't real cops.
Maybe it was the chinks trying to fuck us.
I doubt it. Look, I'll figure it out. But first, we gotta unload this stuff. Vito, take us to the old warehouse in Hunters.
Really hope that cop on that corner doesn't come this way. If he turns left here, we're gonna be in big doo-doo. Nope, he went right. Let's go. Perfect. All right.
Hope this deal goes better than the last one.
Fresh whip.
Not like it can go any worse, right?
So who are we selling the stuff to?
We're gonna go.
A bunch of different guys.
Whoa. What do you mean a bunch of different guys?
A bunch of different guys. What did all that shooting back there make you deaf?
I thought you said we were just moving this garbage from one place to another.
Yeah, well, you make a lot more money if you sell it in smaller amounts.
I'm not down for that, dude.
Before I agreed to go in on this.
If I did, from the way you were talking back in the park, you probably wouldn't have.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, the best you could hope for right now is to spend the next 30 years of your life breaking your ass for Eddie and Carla before you either get bumped off or end up back in the can. The only time you're ever gonna see cash like this is if you stick your neck out. Besides, I ever steer you wrong?
Well, there was the OPA job. And that time we almost got killed when we whacked that fat fucking Sand Island.
All right, enough. None of that matters after today. Let's just get the Hunters. And don't worry, we're never gonna have to see these scumbags again after today.
Unless this turns into a regular thing for us.
Well, all right, let's just concentrate on getting through this one before we go making plans like that, all right?
Hey, I'm just saying.
Vito's right. Let's just get through the rest of the day. After that, smooth sailing, fellas.
See, I'm not really trying to become a dealer, bro. That low-level stuff, yeah, you could make a little bit more money, but there's also significantly more risks. There's that trade-off you gotta do. I'd like to just drop it off in bulk. Let's take our profit. Let's go home and let's be happy. We've already been shot at a few times. We're wanted by the cops. Been chased by the cops a couple times. Like, it's already not looking great. I've already taken way too many risks today. I'm ready to kind of chill out a little bit. You know what I mean? Let's not overstay our welcome. Let's not use up all of our luck. But it looks like we made it to our spot. Where are we supposed to go?
Here we are. Let me do the talking. These are tough guys, so no wise-ass comments. All right, Joe? Hey, guys, how you doing?
Hey, man. Come on in.
Shit! It's smoke! Fuck.
We did it! We hit the jackpot!
Hey, take it easy. We're not done yet.
Lighten up, will you, Henry? What's the matter? All of a sudden, money don't make you happy?
After we pay back Bruno and you get your cut, then you could be happy.
All right.
All right, so it looks like we're making our rounds. We're getting that cash. We're moving that dope. Over here in West Deadtown, baby. Man, I missed that game. I think there's an update coming out for DDS here soon. I think you're going to be able to actually grow, like, different strains and stuff, which is going to be... Gonna be pretty nice. Ooh, these guys aren't happy about it, but we're gonna go ahead and shut them down. It's not the best stuff, but we got the Hero Yayo, baby. It's gonna be addictive, and we're gonna make that money. Cops looking for us? What a smooth talker, bro. Man, these cutscenes are so weird without the music. Just really, really weird. Just love envisioning what's happening. Should I just start adding some sound effects and stuff? Oh, look at us. About to go hit up some ladies. Hey. I'm trying to keep talking because there's no other noise, but I don't really know what to say. All right, bam, there it is. Good stuff. Next up is chapter 13, I believe. Is it 13, 14, 12? We're somewhere around there. We're getting towards the end. I think there are 15 chapters in total. But that should be a wrap on this one. So hope you guys enjoyed. I'm going to see you guys in our next episode. Drop a like if you guys are enjoying the series. And I'll see you guys later. Peace out.